Welcome again to the Red Couch here at the PCIM. And my last interview partner for today is Peter Mies, Vice President Semiconductor Division, Mitsubishi Electric. Thank you very much for joining us this afternoon. And the topic we would like to talk about is power electronics are driving today's and tomorrow's cars. Hey Mies, can power electronics make cars more efficient? Because efficiency is the topic we're talking about all day long. You know that, you're talking about that too.
Exactly, that's a must. I think nowadays, after unfortunate disaster happened in Japan, so everybody is talking about the e-car and also NPE from the Berlin, having this week the first results. So surely, that without efficient power, there will be no possibility for the electrical car or hybrid car or fuel cell cars, the combination. This is absolutely must.
Mm-hmm. Maybe let's take one step back and not talk about e-cars, but what about cars we have today? What part do play power electronics in vehicles today? And what are the most important applications? Because there is already a lot of in there.
Yeah, I think we have the start-stop. We have battery management, and we have the powertrain applications. There's already quite a lot of intelligence, and power is needed. And in the car, you always need efficient, and also you need, let's say, the weight control and so on. This is a very heavy issue, because if you get all the efficiency, but you get not the weight under control and not the features under control, then you're eating up. This is no benefit.
Mm-hmm. So, with new concepts of hybrid and electrical vehicles, you already mentioned that, there will be new challenges for power electronics. So, how could you describe those challenges, and what can you do to solve those challenges?
Yeah, I think the power electronics, so especially from the Mitsubishi part, we have almost 40 years experience in train applications and so on, but believe it or not, already 20 years experience on the hybrid car, mm-hmm. and we can see the quality, robustness, and surely if you like to stay in the automotive, you have to have also the price under control, otherwise you cannot develop such a market. And therefore, I think we believe that the structure of the modules and let's say heat control, solderability, and all this kind of thing is a key activity to stay in this market, develop this market, and also develop the confidence in this market. If you have a car which is not working every day, you don't like to buy a second time.
We are talking about cars most of the time, but what about other kinds of vehicles, like maybe buses or maybe trucks or heavy equipment? How can power electronics improve these kinds of vehicles?
Yeah, in the buses already, or the big trucks, you have the retarder system already recharging energies. You have a lot of saving functions there. And also, I think there's a big project running in the UK, in London, so where all the trucks are not allowed to have any more CO2 emission in mm-hmm. downtown, so which means they go with, I don't know, diesel engine, a hybrid, go until this border and then driving electric and driving through. I think this is a very big issue, and I just came back on the weekend with the plane, and I was thinking about how to make electrical plane. So I think that will be the next challenge, but sooner or later it will come, because I think the most important thing, so the power I'm pretty sure we get under control, but I think the challenge will be, let's say, the battery, the storage. This I think this is a key issue, and if we get all this material and raw material to make the batteries and also make the batteries effective, I think that will be the key challenge.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. There are already a lot of applications using power electronics in cars. Can you imagine other applications that may come in the future that we do not have today?
Yes, so I think the car is a car, but we need to speak about intelligent transportation system. And within this, you need quite a lot of new applications. In the car itself, maybe it's a pedestrian safety that we avoid still, let's say, more accidents, especially with pedestrian. So there's a lot of activities which are not yet there. Then we have also, let's say, the automatic drive. So I still believe I'm 58 years old. I like to have a car by end of my life where I push a button and go from Düsseldorf to Munich. And in Munich, he wakes me up and I said, now you have to drive by yourself to Ottobrunn or Unterhaching. So I believe this technical possible. And so which means in the total system, also if we look about the power grid and rechargeable systems and so on, and the car applications is around 60 million a year, which is nowadays car production. This makes every application possible. And based on these applications and car drive the price down, the cost down, not the price down, but the cost down, with the huge applications. And therefore, you can make a lot of new applications in the industrial field. So, and I'm long enough in contact with the cars. There is much more similarity between a car and a washing machine than everybody believes. Because the washing machine not have the quantities, not have the power to make this technology happen, but the car, in the car itself, you can make all technology happen. So there is around 100 microcontrollers in the car right now. You need already power control for these microcontrollers. And also, we should not forget, if you switch on a PC, oh, you have to wait, in my case, unfortunately, 5 minutes. But if you go to a car, you expect that this 100 micros in 1 second start, and everything has to be also power-driven, power control. You need a lot of control, and these applications easily can go to the industrial part, and I'm thinking to the real applications is a house. Mm-hmm. Because in the car, maybe you have 100 micros. In the house, maybe you have 500 micros. If you have everything under control, it's also network. So I have a lot of opportunities, but first the prices has to come to a reasonable level to start. Mm-hmm. If I ask you to modify your house for 50,000, you will not do. But 5,000, maybe you think about. Mm-hmm.
So I guess you're using a Microsoft operating system.
Yeah.
Coming back to the beginning of your answer, so maybe the car of tomorrow, we're not talking about next years, but maybe 20, 30, 40 years, may look completely different than today?
Yes, it may, but I think, honestly speaking, that's more my private guess. Because why all electrical cars or other cars was not nice? Because, or let's say, not sexy. Mm-hmm. So why you cannot make electrical car looking like a Ferrari? I think there is no reason. Mm-hmm. It was just lobbyism. That some people like to sell the oil, some people like to sell the engine. So if we are coming to the point right now, if you look to the Tesla and all these nice cars now around, I think it will completely change. And surely, we need the success for the battery. The battery is a wide space eater. This is for clear. I think it's not the question of the engines. The engines will be there. Braking will be there. And so it will change completely. And also in this case, I'm very aggressive in this. I always said to my staff, look around, because I still believe the cars can be sold by Aldi, and it can be designed by Apple, because we are going to a new, completely new world, and we will have a lot of new players in this market. And so we make it happen and possible, and it will come. We cannot stop it. Mm.
Your personal guess, how long will it take until electric vehicles are common, until everybody a lot of people will drive them?
Yeah, it's, as I said, we have three cases. So which means the real electrical, then which may be for short distance or town cars. Then we have to have the hybrid and the fuel cell. I think the real that everything will be really electric takes long time because you need to reach 300 or 400 kilometers. Or the total system will be changed, that you, let's say, just have to, your private car around your home area, around 50 or 100 kilometers, and then the rest you go by other traffic system. But I had a friend who rent a car in Munich, and that was had to reach 80 kilometers. And he told me that he has no fun to drive, because he always has to calculate, do I come back home or if I stay overnight? And so this is not fun. And therefore, I think also the infrastructure, especially for the charging, there is a lot of things there, but I think this is a must. And if we once think that you can load everywhere your car, and so there is another dream even to connect all the cars from the countryside via a grid, to use all the batteries as a, let's say, as a big accu for the wind power in the night, or when the industry basically is shutting down, or people are sleeping. You have enough power in order to let's say, save this. It's a dream, but the dream becomes closer and closer. When I heard this 15 years ago, I thought, oh, nice dream. But now somehow becomes realistic. If you have, I don't know, a parking lot of Siemens, or parking lot where thousands of cars, or a stadium football game where you can 2 hours use all this capacity. So there's a lot of possibility and a lot of applications possible.
Mm-hmm. With eco changes, Mitsubishi Electric has a very sophisticated concept that includes, among other things, reducing CO2. How does this concept influence your products for the automotive market?
Yeah, because efficiency. This is. Yeah. I think in the normal semiconductor business, we have the Moore's rule. So every 18 months, we have the double of the capacity and possibility of the transistor development. This was not so very much likely for the power semiconductor, but now it's a must, and it will come, because now we have the driving market, and it will come. We drive down the structures, and driving down the structures of the design rules, I'm pretty sure we get a lot of power saving issues and get more intelligence in the total power. So we surely save. So the aim of Mitsubishi is a long concept up to 2021 to save 30% of CO2. And this is company-wide. If you start Mitsubishi, you have to make a test so that you understand this. And yeah, we are well on the way. And I can invite you to our logo. So this is worldwide the same. And I think we are good on the way to it's right from the beginning. All designers has right from the beginning to have this echo in mind. Also paper saving and all small things, and shutting down power. But we are doing, and it's monthly controlled and measured by top management.
Thank you very much. Peter Mies, Mitsubishi Electric.